Let's say you and I decide to go out to get some lunch. I decide to get a burger with the works, and you're a bit of an alcoholic, so you just decide to skip the food entirely and get three different kinds of beer. Being the kind, sharing people that we are, we each offer the other a sample of our lunch. Even though my burger tastes great and is very flavorful to me, you think it's bland. And on the flip side, even though you got three very different types of beer, they all taste the same and very bitter to me. Why is that the case? Why do different people taste things differently? Let's start by looking at where taste comes from. Taste, scientifically referred to as gustatory perception or gustation, is the sensation we experience when a food or other substance in the mouth reacts chemically with what are called taste receptor cells. These cells are located within your taste buds, which are mostly concentrated on your tongue and each contain 50 to 100 of these taste receptor cells. You've probably heard that you can only taste certain flavors on certain portions of your tongue, but that's not actually the case. The section of the human brain responsible for perception of taste is called the gustatory cortex, which is located right by the areas that control chewing and swallowing. Now, the human tongue, obviously with help from the brain, has the ability to detect and differentiate between five separate elements of taste, which are broadly classified as salty, sour, bitter, sweet, and umami, or savory. These aren't arbitrary categories, rather they've been tested and confirmed to be distinct from one another. Besides the five basic tastes, we all know that smell has a lot to do with perceived flavor as well. When you're sick or have a stuffy nose, food seems bland or tasteless. Other contributors to flavor include texture, temperature, and coolness or hotness, like a mint or chili pepper. This full assortment of sensations gives us the experience we know as taste. Evolutionarily speaking, taste played an important role in survival. Bitterness in foods helped our ancestors learn to avoid potentially poisonous plants, and sweetness helped identify energy-rich foods, which is part of the reason we're so drawn to unhealthy snacks and drinks today. That's basic taste in a nutshell, but why do we experience foods differently? Why is something bitter to me, but not to someone else? The two main components of individual taste perception are genetics and geography. Let's start with genetics. Between individuals, there can be considerable differences of the number and shape of fungiform papillae, the structures that house taste buds. The more of these structures you have, the more taste buds you have. And the more taste buds you have, the stronger the signal sent from your mouth to your brain. These stronger signals cause people to experience flavors, and often smells, much more strongly. These people can often easily distinguish between individual flavors in a mixture. On the opposite side of the spectrum, people with fewer taste buds experience more muted flavors and smells, and cannot distinguish between individual flavors in a mixture as easily. These different types of people are grouped into categories. Those with highly sensitive tongues are called supertasters, and those with much less sensitive tongues are called non-tasters or subtasters. That leaves the people in between with the label middle tasters or medium tasters. Besides differences in flavor intensity, individuals also differ in the sensory capacities for the base tastes. This is due to structural differences of the receptors on your taste cells. The structure of these receptors is purely genetics. For example, there are around 30 different genes for bitterness perception, which each register different levels of taste, with some not even registering the unpleasant bitterness at all. The second main contributing factor to taste perception appears to be linked to where you live and your ethnic background. For example, researchers use a bitter-tasting chemical referred to as PTC to explore individual differences in taste sensitivity. There are certain variants of a particular gene that renders some people unable to taste the chemical, and research seems to indicate that there's a distinct difference in PTC sensitivity between Africans and non-Africans. In these charts, the blue represents the frequency of the gene variant which allows detection of PTC, red shows the non-taster percentage, and gray represents the frequency of variants that confer intermediate taste sensitivity. This map shows the populations with the lowest prevalence of taste sensitivity to PTC. The darker the region, the higher the percentage of the population in the area that can taste the chemical. With the exception of the Aboriginal populations of Australia, the groups with the lowest prevalence of sensitivity to PTC are located in Europe, the Middle East, and India, which has led some researchers to believe that the genes associated with PTC non-tasting were linked with populations that entered Europe from the Middle East after the last ice age. As fascinating as all that is, I'm sure what you really want to know is what kind of a taster you are. Are you part of that special 25% of the population that has a heightened sense of taste, or the 25% that are considered non-tasters? Or are you just a regular middle taster? There are some easy ways to determine the answer, if your food preferences haven't already clued you in. First, you can use blue food coloring to dye your tongue. Fungiform papillae do not stain blue, so they'll stand out very clearly against your tongue. Without someone else's tongue to compare yours to, it might be difficult to tell if you're a non-taster or a middle taster, but it should be clear if you're a super taster. If you want something a little more scientific, you can buy a PTC test kit. Then if you're a super taster, you'll know. But if you can't be bothered to dye your tongue or buy a test kit, here are some usual giveaways. Super tasters typically find things unbearably bitter that most other people don't. Coffee, alcohol, and vegetables like kale are three common offenders. In the end, whatever your taste profile, you obviously have great taste in videos. If you'd like to learn more about the science of taste, check out the links in the description. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't already, follow Second Thought on your favorite social media, and leave a comment down below with what your favorite or least favorite tastes are. You can watch my previous video by clicking here, or watch them all by clicking here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.